Welcome to the UN Consulting Christmas edition. My Christmas gift to you, I'm going to share with you 6 McKinsey secrets. And you know that I spent 5 years as a consultant and project manager myself with McKinsey and Company, and so sometimes I have to be a little bit careful what exactly I say about it. But on this instance, we are very lucky because these secrets were originally shared not by myself but by our former global managing partner Dominic Barton. And I think if he can talk about it, then I also can tell you about them and maybe also give my own spin on them. I can already tell you that in a second I'm going to reveal to you my UN Consulting Advent Calendar, so stay with me. This video is based on an interview by British business magazine Management Today with Dominic Barton. Dominic Barton was McKinsey's global managing partner from 2009 till 2018. And being a managing partner at McKinsey is a bit like being a CEO. You have fewer executive powers than a CEO, but you are the highest representative of the firm. And Dominic Barton was elected managing partner for 3 consecutive terms of 3 years in a row. Very impressive. You can read the article yourself. It's actually quite a long read when you print it, 9 pages. And the article was first published in 2017 and then got updated in 2020. And sometimes it's not absolutely clear what Dominic Barton said and what the interviewer, Matthew Griver, had researched himself. Anyway, my role here is to translate to you what may be hidden between the lines. My name is Dr. Jack Jörg Leib. I'm here to help you with your successful entry, rise, and exit as a consultant. And I'm also sharing my general business and career advice on this channel. Coming to my advent calendar, actually, mine only has 6 doors, 1 secret behind each door. Now let's open the first one. Number 1, McKinsey hiring figures. The article reads, McKinsey gets the cream of the cleverest kids from college and business school. 201,000 applied last year for 2,200 places. This obviously relates to consulting applications worldwide, and a little maths leads to the conclusion that the admissions rate is around 1%. So yes, this reconfirms how competitive the application process is. But don't despair, I'm here to tell you the truth, but also I'm here to help. The article also answers the question on how the majority of applicants would decide between McKinsey and the leading global investment bank Goldman Sachs. It reads, even better, since 2007-2008, one suspects that few of them, given a choice between the firm as it's known to insiders and Goldman Sachs, will have chosen the latter. And I think that's true. Since the financial crisis 2008-2009, the global investment banks have lost some sex appeal, prestige went down, salaries went down. Anyway, what would you pick, McKinsey or Goldman Sachs? Let me know in the comments. Maybe it's a topic for another video in the future. And also, if you want to know more about top consulting firm hiring figures, I recently dedicated an entire video to that topic. Check it out here. Let's open door number 2 together. And we talk about McKinsey employee churn rates. Well, the article reads, McKinsey is famed for its brutal up or out system. And if you haven't made partner within 5 or 6 years, it's goodbye. 25% of the staff turnover annually. Well, first I have to say, I think 5 or 6 years under partner sounds very fast to me. I think most partners need a couple of more years to become McKinsey partner. And there's something else that is also among these figures. So 25% churn rate, that means on average, a McKinsey consultant stays for 4 years at the firm. Now, McKinsey has around 30,000 employees worldwide. And if it really hires 2,200 new consultants every year, that would mean it had around 8,800 consultants in the company. But this is a bit too low, I think, this figure, compared to the other than 20,000 support roles. So I think this number should be a bit higher. So either the churn rate is a little too high in the article, or the number of newer hires is a bit too low. But for sure, we can say the great majority of consultants doesn't spend their entire lifetimes at a top consulting firm. Ready to open door number 3? Let's do it. About McKinsey consultants. Now, this article features a couple of statements made by McKinsey senior partners about McKinsey consultants in general. So for instance, it reads, one McKinsey director or senior partner describes his colleagues as a band of insecure, deeply left-brain, hyper-intellectual, OCD overachievers. Now, this relates to the famous stereotype of McKinsey consultants or other consultants as insecure overachievers. And the idea is that McKinsey consultants are extremely bright, extremely smart, but also a bit insecure in the sense that they always fear they are not good enough. So they strive even harder and harder and harder. And given that they are insecure, also they become a bit easier to lead and to shape. I like what Dominic Barton says himself about McKinsey consultants. The article reads, "In the past, we believed any problem could be cracked by analytics. You know, get the smartest people together, throw them a piece of meat and things will happen. It's not just the sharp and bright that we look for. At McKinsey, you need to be practical, patient and able to build trust. You've got to be able to convince and persuade. You've got to work out how to influence without having power. It's what my predecessor Jan Davis called argue the relationship quotient." I very much like and endorse this statement because yes, you have to master your analytics, master your data, because this will help you to develop those arguments that you need to convince your clients to change something. However, in order to do so, you also have to earn their trust, and this is a challenge on another level. And actually, my former colleague Heinrich on his channel has recently made a video in which he talks about the journey from a number cruncher to a trusted client advisor. I quite like that video, so if you want, check it out here.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas to everybody!
A Christmassy visitor! Very nice and welcome! Oh, really? Let me see if I can change it. Better now? Let's get ready for door number four. The McKinsey price tag. The article reads, "McKinsey people are famous for their Jesuitical self-discipline and hard work. When the US taxpayer coughs up $164,165 for weeks worth of one McKinsey engagement manager plus three associates, the deal is they graft like stink." So, well, McKinsey consultants and also other consultants work very hard, no question on that one. On the figure though, $164,000 per week for one project manager plus three consultants. If we reasonably assume the project manager costs 50% more than the consultants of a team, then you would divide the sum by 4.5, which would lead to an average cost per consultant of $36,500 per week per consultant. And this is too high. And I think in this figure, they are missing other team members, such as the partners, experts, support roles. They also need a budget. And this is not quoted in the context of this figure. So having said that, the overall price tag of $164,000 per week, I think can be reasonable depending on the team size and the task. If you are a consultant yourself and now see these figures and think, actually, I don't earn enough salary compared to the revenue I bring to my company, you may be right, and actually I made two videos on this topic already. If this affects you, check this out. No breaks here in my advent calendar. Let's open door number five. Ex-McKinsey Superman and Women. The article reads as follows. "One of the statistics of which Barton is most proud is that there are 359 ex-McKinsey supermen and women across the planet running $1 billion plus companies," referring to the annual company revenue. "No other organization's alumni come close to this. He prefers McKinsey to be seen as a leadership factory, and look at the list of former McKinsey consultants running these mega companies, such as Vittoria Colao of Vodafone, Sheryl Sandberg of Facebook, Tidjane Thiam from the Prudential Financial and Insurance Company, the multipurpose Eddie Turner, former chairman of the British Financial Services Authority, Tom Peters, business book author, former HSBC chairman Stephen Green, Howard Davies of this parish, former chairman of the NatWest Group Bank Holding Company, even William Hague, former Secretary of State of the United Kingdom, and Chelsea Clinton. It is an impressive list. I just wish he had only forgotten to list one venture." Well, and if you want to know more about the famous networks of McKinsey and other top management consulting firms, yes, I have already made a video on that topic too. Let us open the final door of the advent calendar. Door number six. path to success. The article reads quite a few interesting clues about Dominic Barton's own career path and success in McKinsey. Actually, it's a surprising fact that Dominic Barton tried to become partner at McKinsey 3 times until he made it. So he made it on the 3rd attempt, but most people would give up before, after the 1st attempt, after the 2nd attempt, but he persisted and he even made it. And he said when after his promotion, his career stalled somewhat, so he decided he needed to make a move. He moved from his Toronto office in Canada and took his family with him to the McKinsey office in Seoul, South Korea in 1997. And 3 months after he moved there, the Asian financial crisis broke out. And listen to this. South Korea had 34 banks and Barton reckoned all but 4 of them were bankrupt. The nation's banking system needed rebuilding from the walls up and Barton was in the thick of it, merging companies and creating new regulators. He retains the close confidence of a South Korean president and continues to admire his people for their aggressive ambition, their paranoia about competition and their scrappiness. He went on to Shanghai, filling his contact books with a rich and powerful and judiciously milking an economy that was growing like Topsy. And just as another little nugget, yet Barton's own work-life balance looks precarious. Based in London, he meets 2 CEOs each day, no matter what, and for 240 days a year, he is on a plane. Now everybody can decide for themselves if they want to have that sort of lifestyle. But about his course of success in McKinsey in Asia, and then later on he became the global managing partner. I mean, it's quite common, judged by the stories I've heard from other partners, senior partners, that yes, you can strategically plan the success of your career to a certain extent, but there always is this moment of luck or also bad luck that can hit you in an unexpected moment. You have to be open to opportunity. If you want to know how successful management consulting careers are made and built, then I invite you to check out my new online course, The Management Consulting Guide, link in the description below. I hope it really helps you to strategically plan your own consulting career wisely and maybe also be open to that moment of luck. This brings us to the end of my little advent calendar. I share today with you 6 McKinsey secrets, and I'm going to share many more secrets with you in the future on this channel. Make sure you come back in 2 weeks from now because I think the next video will also become great. And please like, subscribe and share it if you like this video. Last but not least, I would like to thank all of you, my family, my friends, my friendly followers for your support during this first year of the UN consulting journey. You're all part of it. Finally, don't work too hard over Christmas like this guy. Well, I may probably continue working a bit on creating further top quality content for you. You may look forward to it. Merry Christmas!